So the idea was to catch a punji for you guys, but I was unsuccessful. I just think the water is just too warm for them, but I don't want to touch the bait. But I don't want that footage to go wasted, so I constantly get some requests to do some bait presentations for you. So I think I'm going to slap the video together with two bait presentations that I used today, and maybe you guys can use that in the future and catch some big fish in it, and also a BB or two. And guys, please tell me if you're going to use this bait, for what species are you going to use them, and what do you think they're going to work like it for. Okay, awesome. Before I get started with bait, let me talk you through my tackle that I'm using. I'm using the Horizon Zero Heavy, Extra Heavy, and Stella 20,000, 50 pound braid, 180 pound leader. I usually use a 10,000, but I didn't bring it along today because I might fish for some other fish, a bigger fish as well. But the 20,000 will do the job. I can get a good distance with this reel. Then my trace consists of 0.90 hook snoot. 0.90 hook snoot, about 45-50 centimeters long. 8-toe circle hook. And then my deagle dangle, like I showed you in the previous video, is a soft dacron dangle. I'm going to add some foam when I put some bait on. Then a lighter sinker trace so that it can break off. I also make a little knot there, a little bloody knot. Fixed to a one-way Japan power swivel. That just allows when you have the fish on, you see everything is straight, and it's just easier to go through the rocks and over the rocks, and it doesn't get snagged as much. And then on the top section is another piece of about over a meter, 0.90 mono, again tied to a swivel to my leader. So yeah, that's my tackle setup that I'm going to use for a punji today. So let me make you a bait for a punji. Well, firstly, you want a piece of foam, because you're fishing between rocks. You want your bait to lift up a bit and not sit in between the rocks, and the punji can smell it, or the fish can smell it, and he's not able to get to your bait. And it also allows you to have a bit of less snags and less hooks. You get stuck less. So you don't get as the hook doesn't get stuck because it's off the bottom. So yeah, just a bit of high density foam, or like surfboard foam. Just split it open. And I put my dangle on the side. So just slit it open and add your dangle in the middle. Guys, I really want to encourage you to use circle hooks when you fish for fish for the punjis, because they tend to swallow the hooks, and that is a fish that you need to release. The numbers are very vulnerable, so well, please do everything in your efforts to get them back in the water. Clean the chocker. Chocker doesn't look too bad. I had it. I went out on one or two fishing trips and took it back, so I thought it's not going to be that great, but it's still okay. Two diamond shapes, and then you shape it almost the size of your dangle. That is the side. Two thin strips going to use as tentacles, you're going to add to your bait. You want that movement. smell and movement. That's the two most important things when you are preparing a bait. Ah, almost forgot my favorites. Chocolate guts. Get a bit of that pink. And then a bit of that guts. Don't throw this away. That's good bait as well. Keep that for later. Because the projectile of your bait is going to be like that, you want your tentacles to show up and not facing downwards. So you just add one tentacle on each side, your piece of foam. Yeah. See, there's your tentacles on. Now you're going to build your bait around it. There's your chocolate. Front. Mullet on there. Mullet. Slowly releases that flavor. That smell for that matter. And on the other side, another piece of mullet. You can secure it, there's no openings so that your bait can travel. Yeah, I'm gonna get me up this. You guys, is your bait for punji. A hound shark will eat it, a cob will eat it, a spotted gully will eat it, and hopefully in this case a punji will eat it. Well, it does eat it, I know it. I broke everything off. It's a re-tackle. And I've got to change my approach a bit because the water is pushing. And throw a hockey leg. That's the second favorite. Or another favorite of punji. What I do is, guys, just a tip, when you collect an octopus for bait, don't freeze the whole thing in one big mushy bowl. What I do is I take three legs and two at the head, and freeze them separately. That way you just have to defrost only what you need for the day. So this time I went with the 7-0 BKK. Same as we did with the chocker on the tentacle. Just tie it up. It doesn't have to be neat because we're going to cover it in any case. Like a long tentacle. Enjoyed watching my presentation, and I hope you find it fun. said at the beginning of the video, please tell me in the comment section what you will use this bait for, what do you think you'll catch on it. And once again, thank you for watching and please subscribe.